In this video, we're going to answer the question, what are IK ratings? This question relates to a recent video that Gary and Gordon made, in which they reviewed the range of industrial GRP socket outlets from Scame. So if you haven't had a look at that video, then please do go and check it out. Now, a couple of minutes into that video, Gordon took a hammer to one of the enclosures to demonstrate just how tough it was, and he stated that it had an IK rating of 10. But just what is this IK rating and what does it mean? Well, it's kind of similar to the IP rating system, which you can tell from the initials alone. However, the second letter has changed to a K for kinetic, which I'm sure you'll know is one of the types of energy, namely the energy of an object in motion. And in this case, it's the motion of the test equipment. IEC 62262, adopted as BSEN 62262 for the UK, gives a list of IK ratings from IK00 to IK10, which relate to different levels of protection against a certain amount of kinetic energy in joules. In other words, it's a way of measuring the amount of impact from an object that an enclosure can take. The higher the rating, the higher the level of impact protection. So a rating of IK00 has no impact protection, and an enclosure with a rating of IK10, like we saw earlier in the video, has the highest rating that the scale goes to. So we can safely say it was a properly tough bit of kit. In order to carry out the testing, the enclosures are tested in various positions and have specific weights dropped onto them from specific heights in order to achieve the rating. Of course, using different shaped weights are going to create different amounts of impact, and so the shape of the striking face of the weight must conform to certain requirements of size and shape. So there we go. That's an introduction to the subject of impact or IK ratings. But as always, we want to hear from you. We were already aware of impact ratings in connection with electrical equipment. Do you take impact ratings into account when selecting and installing electrical equipment? Do you know the specific requirements in BS 7671 that relate to this subject? Well, please leave all of your thoughts and questions in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.